Welcome student to my channel My Way Learning. To continue with our topic decimal, now let us learn to compare decimals. I take two numbers 4.796 and 4.7296. Now I have to check which of the number is greater. First of all, check the whole part. It is 4 and it is 4. So they both are equal. Now after the decimal, it has 7. It also has 7. Again, equal parts. Now it has 9, but it has 2. So one can say this number is greater than this. But just do the comparison. But one of the another student says, ma'am, there are 5 digits and it has only 4 digits. So this number should be greater than this. Now let us check both cases. I make it equivalent decimal by putting a 0. Now this number will become 4.7960. Now remove the decimal. It will become 47,960 upon 10,000. And this number after removing the decimal will come 47,296 upon 10,000. Now you can easily say which number is greater. This number is much greater than this number. So one can answer it just by comparing the number or by logically this way. These two numbers can be compared. Now let us take another example. 23.86 and 19.86. As the whole part is 23 and its whole part is 19. So this is greater than this number. This way we can do comparison between the decimal numbers. Now let us learn how to add decimal. I take three numbers here. 23.17, 79.678 plus 402.42. Now I have to add all of these three numbers. One can do by this way or another can do by this way. Let us learn what is the difference between these two ways. Just put the decimal at its place and then write down all the numbers after and before the decimal exactly on their places, like 2 place and then 3 place. This 3 place will not come to this side. Most of the time students get confused and they put the number after number as we told them in normal addition. So what they did, they write 8 at this place, 7 at this place, 6, 9 and 7. So in that case your number get totally changed. So what I have to do, just put the decimal and write the number, whatever the number given, on their place only. Don't shift them. As you saw, it is empty. There is no number above and below of it. So it will become 8, 7 plus 7, 14 plus 2, 16. Write down 6 here and 1 is carry forward. 6 plus 4, 10 plus 1, 11 and then 1, 12. Now the second mistake most of the children do, that they write 12 over here. No, we just write 2 over there and that 1 goes forward. The same way we did in the normal addition. Now this number will become 10 plus 5, 15. 1 carry, then 10 and then 1 carry, it gives you 505.268. Now to make it easy, to remove the confusion, what we did, we just make them equivalent decimal by adding a 0. Now this number will become 23.170, 79.678, 402.420. Now add the numbers in the same way and you get the same answer. There is no difference in the answer, but just to avoid confusion, make them equivalent decimal. Now let us learn to subtract decimals. I have 43.2 and 19.786. I have to subtract these two numbers. First of all, what I have to do? I have to make it equivalent decimal. So this number will become 43.200. And then write down the another number, 19.786. The same way which we did in the subtraction, just borrow from the previous number and we do the subtraction. Now, as it is 0, it can't be borrowed from this. It will become 1, this will become 9 and this will become 10. Now, 10 minus 6 give you 4, 9 minus 8 give you 1. It is 1 only. How can we subtract? There is decimal. So, what to do? Just ignore it and go to the next number. As it is 3, it can give it 1 and now this number will become 11. Now 11 minus 7 give you 4. This number will become 2. Again it borrow from the further number. It become 12. Now 12 minus 9 is 3 and 3 minus 1 is 2. So your number will become 23.414. In this way we can do subtraction. So for addition and subtraction, please first convert the number into equivalent decimal by adding zeros. The number of zeros depend on the number of highest number after the decimal. Like in this case it is 3, so I make it put 2 zeros to make it 3. Now let us learn how to do multiplication in case of decimal. I have taken 43.68 multiply with 1.4. Now what to do? I just simply multiply these two numbers in our simple way. So what I get? 61,152. Now you ask, where is the decimal? As the question is of decimal. Now let us count how many decimal places are there. 1, 2 and 1 more. So this will become 3. 1, 2, 3. So now as I find 3 places. 1, 2, 3 after decimal. So just come to this side and count 3 places from back and moving forward. 1, 2, 3. Now put a decimal at this place. If they are only 2, then put a decimal at this place. If they are only 1, then at that place. And if they are 4, for example, if it is also a 2-digit number after the decimal, so the decimal will come at that place. So basically, you just multiply the 2 number and then after count the number after the decimal. It is 1, 2 and 3. So, just count from this and moving forward and put the decimal at that place. I hope this will help you to put the decimal in multiplication. Because this is the only part in which we get confused where to put decimal. Now, let us learn quick way to do calculation, multiplication in case of decimal. For example, if your number is 23.786 and you have to tell me by which number we multiply it give you 2376. You don't know. The same way, if the number is 23.76 and now you have to tell me by which number you multiply it to give me 237.6. In the same way, 23.76 multiplied by which number gave you? 1 tenth, 100,000, 10,000 lakh. 237,600. I think that is very tricky to find out. Now let us learn the easiest way. Let's do. Now I said, if you multiply 23.76 with 100, you will get 2376. Do you agree with me? No. Now let us check how I say, if I multiply this number with 100, give you this, this number with 10, give you this, and this number with 10,000, give you this. Let us check. How many decimal places are there? 2. And there? No. So I have to move 2 times. That means 100. As I said in previous session, every time when you jump, it is of 10. So when you jump 2 times, 1 and 2, it is 100. Now in case of this number, there are 2 decimal places, but there is only 1 left. So how many steps you jump? Only 1. So now you multiply this number with 10 only. Now let us check this number. Here it is 2 decimal places number, but now there are 4. So I need to jump 4 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I multiply this number with 10,000 to make it 237,600. Now let me take this example to explain you further. Now let us understand further why I choose only 4 zeros. Why not take 2, 3 or 5? Let us check. Write down this number. It is 23.76. Now when I remove the decimal, this will become 2376 upon 100. As I said, multiply this number with 10,000. Now this number is in your numerator and this is in denominator. So we can cut these two numbers one by one. So there are 2 zeros which can be reduced by these 2 zeros or cancelled. So what is left with you in the numerator? It is 2376 and 100. You just multiply these two numbers and you get 237,600, which is my required number. So what I tell you, just count the number after the decimal as it is 2 and I need 4. So just multiply with 4 zeros. If it is 1, then multiply with 1 and so on. In this way, we quickly do the calculation without actually doing the calculation. This is the mind calculation. I think I make myself clear. Now you are able to do quick calculation and check out by which number you multiply and you get the required answer. In today's section, we learn addition of decimal, comparison, subtraction and multiplication. I hope now this topic is clear in your mind. For more updates, keep watching my channel and don't forget to subscribe, like and comment in my comment box. Thank you.